After walking home the night, she said, "My God, Paddy, slow down, I can't keep up with you." He said, "Mary, when I'm by myself, I walk twice as fast." Well, I'm glad to know with you when you're by yourself. They called in for some supper into the fish and chip shop. He said, "Fish and chips twice." The fella said, "I heard you the first time." And they're coming out of the chippy, and Mick tripped over the dustbin, and a big cat jumped out of the bin. He said, "Mary, why would anybody throw a good cat like that away?" I met my wife in the tunnel of love. She was digging it. When we got married, she was a bag of nerves. Now she's just a bag. I think she's on the drugs, me, you know. The phone rang on Tuesday, and when I lifted it up, a man's voice says, "Is the dope still there?" She wasn't feeling well. I took her to the doctor. The doctor put a glass tube in her mouth and said, "Don't speak for 10 minutes. I offered him 25 quid for it. Because, you know, my wife has got a speech impediment. She won't shut up. This English fella went into a bank in Dublin trying to pull a fast one on the cashier. He said, "Would you have change of an 18-pound note?" Mick said, "Certainly." "How would you make it now, 2 nines or 3 sixes?" "Got a great new drink now in Ireland. It's Guinness in window, Lean. You still get drunk, but in the morning your eyes are clear." Paddy went to the doctor. The doctor said, "I got bad news for you, Pat, and I got very bad news for you. The bad news is you've got 24 hours to live. And the very bad news is I tried to phone you yesterday." He went home to his wife. He said, "Mary, the doctors give me these pills. I have to take them for the rest of my life." She says, "What's wrong with that?" He said, "He's only given me 4. Mary sent her lad to the shop last week. She said, "Go down and get me 10 pounds of potatoes, and don't get those big ones, they're too heavy to carry." Mick lost his job in the butcher's. It took him 5 hours to hang up the mince. Went for this job, and a fella says, "Well, I have a fella here today who hasn't turned up, Mick. If he doesn't turn up tomorrow, I'll send him home, and you've got the job." "But we work a system here in the company called the week in hand. You'll get paid the week on Friday." "Ah, no problem. I'll start the week on Thursday." He said, "Look, mate, go over to the storeroom and ask Sean for the big tin of green paint. Go down to my house and paint me porch." He came back about 5:30, covered in paint. He said, "I've done that job for you, sir. And by the way, it's not a porch, it's a Mercedes." Went down to the shop to get himself a sandwich and said to the girl, "Are those fresh cream cakes in the window?" "Oh," she said, "as fresh and as pure as the girl of your dreams." He said, "How much are the meat pies?" She said, "They're £1 for 2. He said, "How much for one?" She said, 75 pence. He said, "I'll have the other one." He saw Sean last night. He said, "Sean, where were you going yesterday morning when I saw you going to work?" He said, "I was going to work." "I thought of it," she said. "When I got up to you, you were gone." "Are you still working with Mick?" He said, "No, Mick's dead." "Ah, God, how long has he been dead?" He said, "Well, if he'd lived to next Thursday, he'd have been dead a month." "What did he die of?" "Oh, nothing serious," he said. "A steamroller ran over his finger. He was hicking his nose at the time." I packed a job now. He said, "The job was murder. I had to work a thing called shift work. I had to work 3 days on nights. Then it was 3 nights on days. And all day Saturday morning. And the hours I had to work 12 hours a day." He said, 6 to 6. The barber says, "I work 14 hours a day, 7 to 7. And you know what? I'm going to close the pub down and open the brothel." Mick said, "If you couldn't sell drink, you'll never sell soup." You want to see his wife? She had one tooth in her gob. She could chew poldermints without breaking them. He had a face like a saint, Bernard. And she loved the one-armed bandits, you know. He wakes up every morning with a mouthful of 50 P's and the rupture. Sean was at the dance on Friday. He said to me, "How did you get in here?" He said, "I slipped the doorman a fiver and he let me in for nothing." "But none of the girls would dance with me," he said. "I don't know why." He said, "Well, I know why. Your feet stink. Go and change your socks and they might dance." He saw him 20 minutes afterwards. He said, "I changed my socks and they still won't dance." He said, "Well, where's the pair you took off?" He said, "They're in my top pocket." This 18-year-old girl came to his door last week and said, "I'm from the catalogue." He said, "I don't remember sending for you." And the old folks went off on a mystery coaster last week in County Kerry, and they had the raffle to guess where they were going, and the driver won £47. This English lad is in a pub in County Kerry, and he said to the barman, "A pint of Guinness, a brandy, and whatever you want yourself." And he gave the barman £20 note, and the barman gave him 2 pence change. He said to him, "What did you have?" He said, "A pair of hush puppies." And he's bragging to Mick about the marvellous job he's got in England and how much money he earns for wages and the big car he drives and the house he lives in. He said to Mick, "You know, I've got a Porsche." He said, "A Porsche? I've got 2 garden sheds and a greenhouse." This little lad came into the bar and was all bent over double. He said to the barman, "A pint of Guinness, a brandy and a drink for the lads." He got the bill, it was £17. He said, "I've got no money." And the barman said, "If you'd done that in Murphy's bar, they'd break your back." He said, "I just come from there."